Well, maybe. We're still waiting on one member, and there they go. So let's switch on over. I didn't actually switch over. There we go.
I think you're a little bit ahead of me. Hold on. Let me re-click Leo. What's your timer at, Blake?
I am at 54, 53.
Okay, we're completely in sync.
We are all perfectly in sync with each other.
Oh my god.
Delicious.
Feel perfectly bad, man. In sync? Oh
all
my.
All three of us.
God.
Wow.
I guess you could say bye bye bye. Don't ever want to make it up.
I just want to tell you that I had enough.
It might sound crazy, but it ain't no
ain't
lie.
No lie, baby. Bye, bye, bye. Bye, bye.
Sorry. You were in sync. I couldn't help it.
Zero apologies for what just
don't ever apologize for that, please. That was fantastic.
So we're going to Rainmaker Arowana. This is a really great map for Rainmaker. Rainmaker did nothing wrong. It's amazing. I just like to say Arowana on this map, like I've been saying every other time, you want to hold both closes and you want to have someone in that mid. Interesting choice with the Sloshy Machine. Arrow is a Sloshy Machine main, but it always freaks me out.
It's a really rock solid. Really, I mean, as a Sloshing Machine main, it is so good on this map.
It's devastating, especially because you can sit on close and shoot over that wall into the open. And anyone who's sitting there is just free kills. It's free so kills. Annoying.
Sloshing Machine is also actually the perfect counter to snipers on this level because it basically can reach up and hit any of the little lips or ledges that snipers really like to hide out on and kind of camp. So Sloshing Machine is absolutely a great choice for this map.
And there we go, himself getting a kill. Also, man, matching a breakthrough, are really matching a breakthrough in all their members right now.
Yeah,
really
very
pushing
solid
forward.
First push.
Mm-hmm. And that constant aggression. Silver's still up there, just causing a little bit of havoc. The one thing I will say is that we are watching Leo, who is one of our teammates. And he is a fantastic Tentatech. He is the greatest player that we've ever met alive.
Literally ever.
This is a totally unbiased stream, just so everyone
don't
knows.
Don't know the meaning of the word.
Leo gets nice kill, but gets taken out by the Rainmaker. It looks like they're gonna make a push. They
it
might actually
a
grab
counter.
The lead on this
it
one.
Is. There
oh,
they go.
Oh,
they got it to the 12 mark. That might actually
solid.
Be a loss for matcha breakthrough.
Yeah, that's solid the thing about Arowana Mall. Like, you can run away with the Rainmaker so quickly, but I mean, it's like, as shown in Squidstorm Finals, that you can think that you have a really solid, secure win, but 12 is not necessarily safe,
this
in my
is,
opinion.
This is really bad. None of them are touching the Rainmaker. It's like the first rule of, like, Rainmaker Arowana is you need to get that out of that 12 area at all costs. They took way there too long to grab that Rainmaker, and that is scary. That is a scary thing to do.
Yep, now the sniper's all in position. We've got the killer whale ready. It's gonna be hard to push out now.
Wow, dude, that was some beautiful insight, man. I couldn't have said it better myself.
Thanks, man.
So we have you on the stream, man. If everyone doesn't know, we'll just plug in the middle. This is 1-2-Q, a variety streamer, but streams mostly Splatoon and does a ton of viewer battles. One of the biggest community members helping us out today.
You're so nice. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem, man.
I just and the man wears a fantastic tank top.
Yeah, I'm close to becoming a tank god. I'm just letting you know. It's close. I'm one third of the way there. It's gonna happen.
One third of the way. Just 66 more hours to go. You got this.
Don't worry. It's only 1 week.
I do not stream 60 hours a week.
Oh, you will.
I'm so fucking dead if I try that.
And because I forgot to do it earlier, I have started the betting. You put exclamation point bet, followed by the ID 0 for matching a breakthrough, or 1 for Phoenix, followed by the amount of points that you want to bet. With a 25% payout rate, bet as many points as you want on that winner, and you can earn some extra points and get to that elusive 500 points necessary to get all 5 raffles to make.
So another thing that we'd like to add, well, that I'd like to add at least to this, is that It looks like Matching Breakthrough is finally being able to push out. They have control more of the mid than Phoenix does, but they can't seem to push it back because Phoenix is playing very defensively, but intentionally. Like, they're not being pushed back. They're just deciding to hold back. Now, in a lot of teams, people think this is like a good strategy, but you have to be very, very confident in your defense to do this kind of strat, because it means that someone will push through and one mistake can cost you the game.
Yeah, it seems like it'd be like a more like conservative strategy, but it's, I feel like it's almost like a higher risk.
Oh,
the reward's basically the same, right? Like, I don't understand why teams.
Yeah,
do it,
I usually feel like in the game of Splatoon, because the maps are so small, it almost always benefits you to be more offensive than defensive as a team. You have to be so confident in your positioning in Splatoon to be a great defensive team. I feel like it's 100 times harder to play defensive than offensive, at least in this game.
I'd also like to take a brief second to call out chat. There have been several people who bet one point on a 25% payout. You earn 1 point back.
I'm going to give them the benefit of the doubt and say a lot of them don't really understand how betting works, so...
So 5 seconds left. It looks like they picked it up, but yeah, exactly. Phoenix will take it. So game one
Sloshing
goes to Phoenix.
Hype.
I have to say, Slosh Machine got a couple of kills on Leo there.
I just saw where Sarah said maybe they should, you know, match a breakthrough. Thought it was great.
Look at that, top of the ticket, Sloshing Machine. Way to go, babe.
Alright, and with that, we will close betting with an even 5-5 split on who's going to win.
Sure, like, just so everyone knows, I have officially changed my name for tonight on my Twitter account to Black and Spoon number 9, so everyone knows where to go to get the live updates. What? Gotta please the fans, you know? So it looks like Leo is going for his Forge strats. Okay, so now this is where we get super meta, because we know everything about our team. Leo, we found out. Me and Leo were just chilling, and we were playing some Splatter Shot Pros for fun. And Silver just goes, hey, you know, if you stack 2 mains of strength and 2 subs of strength, you can 2-shot people if they touch your ink once. And we went... Oh my god, no way! And so we all just started using Splatter Shot Pros for like a week now. And I'd say it's been working with like semi-good results, but we're just stubborn and we just keep using it regardless. So let's see how Leo does. I'd say it's pretty good on this map in particular, just because camp zones, you get that decent range going across the mid, and you can zone people really well trying to go through the elbow. I like longer range weapons on this map. I find they work really well, and usually a 2-2 split, at least for zones. Oh, and that quick carbon kill. I feel like he didn't really pay attention too much to that. I mean, it felt like it was almost bound
to happen. Yeah, it may have been that he wasn't paying attention to the minimap very much and was just trying to get there as quickly as humanly possible.
But you gotta know, the other team's gonna get there before you, right? Like.
Just depends on their hustle. I've gotten to the elbow a lot faster than enemy teams before. Really just kind of depends on the situation, yeah. But
they're more concerned of getting to the elbow or trying to shoot the zone from the other side.
But you know they have the roller. He's not going to do anything from the other side. But that's me.
So it looks like Leo getting a nice aggression. They finally get the ball. Oh my
nice.
God, what a great kill.
Nice.
Oh my god.
Oh.
All right, yeah, so this little
this
right here.
Splatter Shot Pro completely worth it now because he got a ball.
That's the thing with this little corner right here heading down into the street is that if you're really good with your positioning on splat bombs, you can just absolutely eliminate and keep anybody from coming up the street, and then you can watch the wall right above your head. Which, again, is a really ideal spot for a Sloshing Machine to hang out on, because you can just really abuse those lobbing shots. And then especially if you've got a little bit of bomb range up, you can also retake your own zone from the enemy's zone. So Leo's in a really, really, really strong position. As long as he doesn't get overwhelmed by specials or overextends, he should be dying to a sloshing machine.
Arrow, the sloshing machine god.
Arrow is making me so proud tonight.
It's kind of weird that his name's Arrow. Like, I know it means like arrow, not in the sense of like an arrow, like A-R-R-O-W, but you know, if it was an arrow, he plays a weapon that isn't straight. It just seems kind of weird. Anyway, so enough of my stupid logic. Yeah, yes, I know. we're talking more about the arrows like the chocolate bar. Those bubbles, you know?
Yep.
Which is still weird, because you think you use a bubble weapon then. Oh, whatever.
Spoon, I have no idea what you're talking about.
So, I'm just...
You didn't make any aerospray jokes.
Yeah, whatever.
I don't know if I should be impressed or disappointed.
I didn't even realize the aerospray existed at the time of me making those jokes.
That's fair. It's very forgettable.
So, it looks like matching a breakthrough, still doing pretty well. Oh, but Silver
Leo
goes down again.
Leo sacrificing Silver. Very nice.
Baiting. Getting himself cornered, though.
Cornered, or is he lulling them into a false sense of security?
I don't know. Swift is a pretty intelligent player. I don't think that he's going to fall for it.
I think pretty much what Leo's doing right now, he's actually playing pretty smart. He's making sure that they can't flank so that they can keep their zone covered. And then he's slowly going to push up. So yeah, he made a really smart play right there. Just making sure he could hold back, making sure there was no flanks happening until their own zone was secure. And look, now they're pushed up. They're getting that lead. I feel like this is a win at this moment. I don't know how they can come back.
Yeah, because he's... Leo.
Oh, that killer. Ooh. Oh, the whale and bubble synergy, though. That was some nice play to get that zone back by Phoenix.
It was some good teamwork there.
Yeah, great teamwork on them.
But secretly a Silver.
Oh, Silver gets it back.
Hiding in the pocket corner.
And that's it. 1-0.
There it is.
And there we go. Match a breakthrough takes in and ties it up. For a very nice game on Camp Triggerfish Zones. Now, surprisingly, Leo hates this map, okay? He absolutely hates this map. So for him to win, this is a big victory. He's going to be so pumped, man. It's going to be like right through. I expect you a 3-1 right now, but this is mostly my biased talk. If you can overcome Camp Triggerfish Zones, you got this.
Let's get some poison chat for Leo for a... winning on his least favorite map.
So to those of you who have just turned in, we're giving a Pokemon Sun and Moon copy at the end of the stream. The more you watch, the more chances you have to win. It's based on a point system. Also, guys, we're going to be giving away a bunch of prizes in the next week's tournament for Thanksgiving. To be thankful for the Splatoon community and be thankful for everyone who supported us for the entire weeks. We're also opening up a donation drive for everyone who wants to donate and help give away prizes to the community and to the players who win. We want to make this as big as it can possibly be. We've all given in and chipped into it already, and we've also received some donations from my stream. So any more is always appreciated.
'Tis the season for giving.
Yeah, man, I'm giving away everything. I mean, this is the Sun and Moon copy. We're giving it to you guys. No donations. This is just us thanking you guys for watching.
Spoon, if I wanted to donate, how would I do that?
So if you want to donate, you just splat that donate button that is right below the stream. You can pay by PayPal, and you get a nice shout-out on stream with some beautiful music, and your name gets put up on the top donators list.
And we'll love you a little bit more than we love everybody else.
Oh, we'll love you. And you'll definitely get a bunch of shout-outs during the Splatsgiving.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You think that we're biased now. You donate to us? Oh, we'll go above and beyond.
Oh, man, if you donate and you play this game, don't even want to know how good of a player you are. Before play, we're going to think you're the best.
We will stoop to the lowest levels to promote you and make you look so good. Oh. You don't even know.
So I'd just like to point out that Phoenix got a really nice push at the beginning. They took out a couple of members of Matching a Breakthrough and got a decent push off. I mean, thankfully, the sniper was there to take him out. But yeah, relentless aggression so far by Phoenix.
I mean, that's just definitely something that they've proven in every single time that they've entered in Bleck and Spoon, is they are contenders. They're not a team to be underestimated or taken lightly, for sure.
Oh, yeah. I mean, in all the... I mean, they've entered the past three Bleck and Spoon, and they've always either qualified or had some crazy intense games. I love watching Phoenix Splatoon play. So, if Matching a Breakthrough beats Phoenix, this is... I would say it's a huge upset, considering this is just a pickup group, and Phoenix has been around for a while. Mm-hmm. Froyo gets taken out. Leo with some nice distance, showing that he really knows the range of his weapon.
I always underestimate the range of Tenantuck.
Oh, I underestimate the range of all my weapons, except
for That's what happens when you only play one weapon.
Right?
Yep. Oh, and he gets a nice kill on Arrow! Oh my god! Oh, nice double! No, it's not a double! He got his kill!
He got saved!
He got saved.
His teammate with a 6 save.
Bro, what a bro.
Oh, and a beautiful Izuka shot.
Man, Leo on fire. Looks like someone's getting on the tower. Leo pushing up. This might go pretty strong in their favor. Phoenix members are all up, but I feel like there's just so much ink coverage for Matching a Breakthrough at this moment that they can easily get that lead.
Kind of pushes theirs.
Oh, and they got it. Yeah, this is gonna
Neo's
be very
dodging that roller like a boss.
They're gonna stop it. A better spot would have been if they could get it to the middle of that platform. While,
yeah, but
not quite safe. It's a good place to be in.
This is still a really strong push, and they're still on the tower. Oh, and he gets taken out.
Well,
that's
Jackie?
A good argument.
I'm just being a smartass.
Oh. Well, fine.
All right then.
Didn't want to have any banter with you anyway.
There's plenty of time for that. There is plenty of time for that. The night is young.
Ooh, Leo getting another kill. He sees the sights on the next guy, but gets taken out. Man, he's having some hard time against Arrow. I feel like all his death cam have just been the sloshing machine.
Good sloshing machines are almost fucking impossible to deal with. Like, they just have so much range and great time to kill. Like, it's a really good kit, and it got shit on as a meme for a long time, but it's nice to see people proving that wrong.
That
you know what? Before Hitzel gets in here and continues to shit all over the sloshing machine, which he regularly does, I think probably just because he knows me really well, and it's my main. It is an incredibly powerful, versatile weapon. There are many different kits that you can wear with it if you are really into, you know, having a lot of ink, or if you want to do damage, or you want to do defense, or swim speed. But then especially on things like splat zones, and especially tower control, because its shot radius is so small, and it has that really awesome arc and range to it, it can be really devastating on this mode.
So it looks like Phoenix is going to try and make a push-up. As you can see, Matching a Breakthrough just kind of naturally started playing more defensive. I still don't like this thing. I feel like every team's mentality, even we do it on Q, we're like the worst offenders for this, is that we all of a sudden intuitively play passive once we have a lead. And I feel like it's just the worst way to go about trying to keep a lead. But I feel like they're going to hold it. I mean, it seems like they do have decent positioning. They have a long way to go to get to the 30 mark, but, you know, just ride that tower a little bit, guys.
Yeah, I'd like to see Matching a Breakthrough take a bit more of their ground back before pushing up past this halfway point. They're still leaving a lot of avenues where it'd be real easy for Phoenix to make a quick sweep in and flank.
Well, no, there's 8 seconds left. They finally got that whole mid-side up. I feel like Matching a Breakthrough definitely has this. Leo's on tower. He's completely in control on both sides. Yeah, and that's it. That's definitely game.
Solid win. GG's.
Yeah, GG's to Matching a Breakthrough. Going 2-1 so far. This is now match point for Matching a Breakthrough and all their members.
But,
All right, Tomo taking their set 3-0 against EDPP.
Very I'd say nice. That's surprising. EDPP's not seen to be taken lightly, so the fact that Tomo 3-0'd them really shows that Tomo is, you know, definitely on their game today.
Tomo's been a good team for a while, though.
Yeah,
oh, no, no, for sure. Both teams are great, but that's what I mean. Normally, you'd expect, like, a 3-1, a 3-2. You know what I mean? Like, some games being taken off, like, some really close games. So for a 3-0, it's very surprising. It's not that I'm taking anything away from both teams. I'm crediting both teams for their amazing play.
I understand. I just didn't want to be taken out of context. Zool, that's what you get for trying to use, like, insider information, man. You just always gotta bet with your heart, not what's already happening.
Yo, if anyone in the stream is a Redditor, if anyone could please post our stream to Reddit saying that we're doing a Pokemon giveaway and we're gonna have some great games, it would be greatly appreciated, guys. I'll love you forever. I'll even give you a shout-out if I see your link on Reddit.
To be honest, just post it everywhere.
If it's a social media, if there is a human being on the other side of a computer somewhere, shout it out.
Go spray paint it on a wall, write it on the rooftops, all that shit.
So another thing I'd like to add is that this is a Rainmaker game, and we, and on BNS, everyone needs to hope that there's a KO. It doesn't matter how close the game is, there needs to be a KO. Because we need to see that dunk cam, okay?
We want that dunk cam.
Everything. Someone in the stream is asking how the giveaway works. So guys, we're gonna have a raffle in between 2 points in time, in between the bracket stage and near the final. The more you watch, the more points you gain. You have up to 5 raffle tickets that you can gain. You get 10 points per 5 minutes. So the longer you stay, the more chances you have, up to 5 more chances to win a copy of Pokemon Sun and Moon. So everyone just keep watching, tell your friends about it. And yeah, that's it.
And if you haven't followed the stream already, if you do follow the stream, you will immediately get 100 points, which equates to 1 free raffle ticket right out of the gate.
Oh, and Leo with a flank on the sniper. Oh, we get taken out by the brush. That sneaky brush. Oh my god.
I hate Octobrushes because of stuff like that. All of a sudden, they just pop up on you, and it's just this flurry of action in your face, and it's like, ugh!
I feel like Froyo was like Batman. Like, he lived in the darkness. He's like, I'm just gonna sit in this game. Ain't no one gonna catch me.
Oh, the push! Oh,
that was very a nice really push during push. A nice. Slap Bomb rush. Giving him that excellent cover so that way Leo couldn't just dive in and stop him early.
Alright, put some hype for Leo. Somebody was talking shit about him. He went down as soon as I started talking about him.
Caster's curse.
I want Leo to dunk this.
Alright guys, now I Am Drummer, or Nick Knock, has in fact posted the stream to Reddit. Now, if everyone can please upvote it, it'd be greatly appreciated. We love you all to death.
Quick hop in, get your free internet points.
So to everyone who's watching, no, we are only giving away Pokemon Sun and Moon today. The big giveaways and prize pool will be on Thanksgiving, because be thankful for everything the Splatoon community has done, and be thankful for how great everyone is within this community.
And how great you guys are for hosting this fantastic tournament.
Well, thank you. And great for hosting the best stream.
Best love circle.
Yeah.
By the way, Crip, I've been meaning to compliment you. Your stream looks absolutely beautiful tonight. You're doing a really good job.
I know. My stream is fantastic today. I just want to point that out.
You put so much work into this, and I don't think that you get thanked enough. So, good job. Good job on this stream.
So I want to say that Phoenix is doing a really good job holding on to this left side. They have complete ink coverage in that whole mid area. It's going to be really, really hard for matching a breakthrough to match a breakthrough.
Unless they match a breakthrough.
So for those of you who don't know what Machikino Breakthrough is, it's an ancient Japanese proverb made by the legendary Moyakawa of NIS. In the olden times, you know, pre-apocalypse Splatoon universe, Moyakaya and JFG, ancient teams, legendary teams, almost like a legendary Pokemon, played scrims together. And when JFG had a crushing defeat of 18-0, Moyakawa said, "I think you need to match a breakthrough in all members." And thus, it was ingrained into a law. And that is the proverb, guys.
Beautiful.
Words to live by.
So as we get back into this game...
Shout out to Leo mid-match, just types in, "Please send help."
So it looks like Phoenix is going to push it out. 50 seconds left. I don't know. It feels like Phoenix is definitely has control this entire game.
It's yeah.
Be very, very difficult for them to come back, especially with how much pressure they're putting on. Phoenix takes it all the way really far on that left side. I don't know. It's going to be very, very difficult.
It's Leo just sitting in a... Oh, shit. The Ubru. Donating $15. Thanks for the donation, Ubru.
Ubru! We
didn't say anything.
What?
Is there any comment?
Let's see.
Well, do we want it? Oh, boy. It could be anything.
Ubru, thank you for the donation. Ubru is one of the people currently drawing for our prize pool on the Thanksgiving Day special. So big thanks to her donating and putting in work for us. If that's what we call Thanksgiving, man. And she's even Canadian and she's celebrating American Thanksgiving for us. So thank you.
And Ubru's message was, "Thank you for the good content." Winky face. Aww. Thumbs up.
Should have been, "I'm the best artist ever, TBH.
I mean, that's just saying facts.
So I'd also like to point out that we do have some amazing artists, and I'd like to say it's probably their first time getting a prize pool drawn by them. Cammy, who's done a couple of Splatoon commissions, really great artwork, and Inky Heart, who's also very, very popular within our community. They've both generously are willing to draw the prize pools and some viewer giveaways, so kudos to all of them, and I can't wait to see how all those drawings will turn out next week when we have some winners of viewers and winners of tournaments.
I'd also like
to be honest, the Splatoon community has so many amazing artists. I'm in awe every day. I'm on Twitter. I'm like, "Who the fuck drew that? Who drew that shit?" And then my brain just melts because I'm just in awe of something that I can't even begin to imagine how to accomplish.
I'd also like to take a moment to point out that even though I set up the alert and the sound, that thoroughly terrified me and I was not ready for it, and I hope none of you were either, so that way we could have shared in that experience. Me and you, the viewers at home. The rest of these casters don't know. Spoon knows.
Oh, I know. Blake was testing out.
I actually have no idea what you guys are talking about right now.
Basically, the John Cena theme plays whenever we get a donation.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh, Leo gets a really nice kill on the right plat and takes the entire platform. This is what we've personally taught Leo how to play. All credit to this game, if they win, goes to me for killing him to always go on the platform. Look at this beautiful play right now. Thank God I taught him this.
Spoon taking all the credit for another team's success.
Yeah, leave it with some great plays.
If there's one thing you can always count on a support player to do is to tell you how to play the game better. We know exactly how these games should go.
True facts.
So guys, we're at 96 viewers right now. If we can get over 100 or 125, that'd be fantastic. Oh, and Liam gets taken out, but they have a huge countdown timer. I feel like Phoenix is probably going to cap the zone, but I don't think that they'll keep control for too long.
I don't know. This map is easy to get control and force out and just lock out a team.
Oh, but Froyo gets taken down. He was one who was controlling that mid area. And a bomb rush, and yeah, just like that, they take it right back. Froyo dying was probably the most vital part of that, because he was the one in the middle keeping control of that zone.
And close range weapons just make it so hard to drop down to actually go and reclaim the zone. But Froyo dying was huge.
Yeah, because Froyo was such a pivotal part of keeping that zone covered. Anyways, Leo keeping it controlled. Oh, and he gets taken out by... Every time we mention it, it's because Leo didn't go up on the platform.
The key to Leo winning is for us to not talk about Leo.
We should stop talking about Leo right now because I bet on him. But also, quick shout outs to Swift for I'm pretty sure every single game that has been played tonight so far, he's rocked a different weapon and done really well with it. He's just a very prolific player who can pretty much pick up anything and be really comfortable with it.
We tend to have a lot of those players at BNS somehow. Swift, you, Riolu. We have Rocket, who's incredibly good at picking up multiple weapons. All these players we've highlighted at BNS. Hopefully Swift, you know, gets a capture card so we can definitely show him off in our tournament and show what a great player he is.
And another donation. Shoutouts to Team Simple Flips.
Thank you, Scat Monkey, for donating $7. You just scatted us a donation. Oh no, and Phoenix Splatoon capping that zone, bringing it down to 29. Leo gets an airstrike going to stop it running, and they reset it.
Recap.
Oh my god, this can go right. This is gonna go right down to the line. 30 seconds left. There's gonna be a minute down if they keep it capped. And they don't keep it capped. Oh, with the sloshing machine!
Oh.
Great play by Leo.
That was super nice.
That was a good play.
Oh, and pulling aggro to jump to safety. Very nice, Leo.
Did you say he just pulled out?
I did. At just the right moment, too. Can't teach that kind of success in school.
See, there we go, talking about again. Talking about him.
And Arrow takes him out again to keep that zone capped. This is looking really rough. I feel like what, at this point, Matching and Breakthrough has to do is just play a little bit more calm, keep those special charge, and just wait for the last minute. It's going to go down to pretty much whoever can get the knockout. They kind of just have to worry about overtime at this point. So no matter what the score, you know, just kind of keep it going. Make sure that you can have that zone capped for when it goes into overtime. And there we go. You see the specials drop. They're making their breakthrough at this point.
Jordan hitting that beautiful donation of $20. Jordan Heron, as a fellow TO, I want to thank you for making a tournament what it should be. Thanks.
Jordan, what a legend you are. We love you so much here at Black and Stone.
Jordan the god.
Jordan forever in our hearts.
All of chat's like, turn the volume down, but the whole point is for it to be loud. Right? It's fucking John Cena. Gotta be loud.
Turn it down, it's too loud. No.
Oh my god, Leo gets the nice double. Oh, is he tapping because the team's down? Oh my god, and Phoenix takes it 3-2. GG's to Phoenix for
I'm gonna
a
have
great
to verbally
set
berate Leo.
Turning the volume down will cost you at least a $5 donation.